Yeah, so Web3 Academy, first of all, is a media platform which aims at guiding entrepreneurs, businesses, and creators into Web3. So we have a podcast and newsletter on that, and we're basically just talking about how do you actually use this stuff in business to create, you know, thriving communities, to create sustainable business models, instead of how do we speculate on this like most of the stuff is on Twitter and elsewhere. And so along with that, we created the Rabbit Hole course. And this is really, everyone goes down the rabbit hole in Web3. We wanted to just sort of give some guidelines on like, hey, when you go down the rabbit hole, here's the things you should really understand. Just basically trying to outline the ethos of Web3 and like what this stuff really means. So people can get a better grasp of it, because I think a lot of the stuff out there is a lot of fluff. It's confusing. You don't know what you're really understanding if you're listening to Bitcoin people, if you're listening to ETH people, if you're listening to whatever. So we just want to kind of lay it out of like, hey, here's what's actually going on in the space. Here's the places you should be looking. And just give some more details on what Web3 is and where it's going. So I run a marketing agency for crypto companies in the space, mainly media platforms. So we work with a lot of companies like Bankless and Real Vision and many others. And a lot of them are focused on markets and pricing and speculation and investing. And we noticed there was sort of a gap on like, what if I want to actually build? Where do I get that information? And what if I want to, and maybe I'm not a developer, but I want to know how I can launch an NFT or why I should launch an NFT. Or, you know, I want to launch a DAO, et cetera. And so we thought, you know what, maybe we can be the media platform for that. And so that's what kind of got us to start Web3 Academy. The reason we started the rabbit hole was everyone I met in the space that was kind of learning and new to Web3, I realized like they all had different perceptions and perspectives of what they thought Web3 was. You know, some thought it was just a money thing. Some thought it was, you know, this like world computer, and some thought it was just these NFTs of arts. And I'm like, no, there's so much more going on. Like, you got to really understand what this thing is from a zoomed out point of view. And so we did it just kind of to solve that problem. Yeah, so Unlock, we've actually been tracking for a while. I've just seen what Unlock was doing. I thought it was really cool. And so we actually had Julian on our podcast months ago. So that was kind of where it first started. But really, when we completed the course, we said, well, we'd like to give people an NFT if they complete the course. And how can we do this? I'm not a developer. We do have a developer on our team, but he's not a developer in Web3 by any means. So we said, okay, well, how can we create an NFT that can't be sold? So a soulbound NFT that proves someone has completed the course. This is not only just a cool feature, but it also helps people learn how to use Web3 and mint an NFT and so on. And see it in their OpenSea account. And so we got in contact with Julian and the team at Unlock, and they were like, yeah, we can do this. Of course, it's fairly simple, which overall it was fairly simple to do. And so, yeah, we just implemented it there because it just made sense. I wasn't really the one that set it up, so it's hard to say, but it wasn't very long. I think it was like under 2 weeks until it was like fully ready and everything was ready to go. So it was fairly simple. We're growing super fast right now. It looks like there's a lot of hunger and a lot of want to understand the utility of Web3. And so we're growing significantly there. The Rabbit Hole course has had a lot of really, really good reviews. So many of them come into our Discord afterwards. Because we're actually started a DAO in there as well, and we're just doing a bunch of community events and stuff. And so we get a lot of people coming in just saying like how great that course was, and it really kind of gave them some direction to go off of. And everyone loves sharing their NFT. So I think it's especially for a lot of our people, they're kind of new, and a lot of this is actually their first NFT. So they really love that experience. And for the most part, it's been very easy for people to claim it because Unlock creates sort of their own sort of checkout process. So it's very similar to like a checkout process of if you were to just buy anything in the Web2 world. So I think for users, it's actually easier than if they were to mint from a different website or something. So yeah, we've had very minimal issues with minting. Yeah, so at the moment, it's just a proof of completion. However, the idea of it for us and the reason we did it, we made it as an NFT, is so that we could do things like that. So there will definitely be something, whether that's future airdrop or future access to something, or we are launching merch. So maybe those who have this get a discount on the merch. We're not sure what that utility will be yet. We're still in kind of early stages of this DAO. So we're sort of in organization phase. But the whole idea was those that go above and beyond, take this course, go and mint an NFT, we want to reward them in some way in the future. And so whether that's via DAO or it's via Web3 Academy, they're two separate things. We're not sure, but we will definitely use it in some way in the future. Now we're just focused on creating the best content possible. So we really just have over the next couple of months is focused on just like getting the best people on the podcast, really kind of configuring and improving and optimizing our newsletter and just getting the best content out there across multiple platforms. The goal from that though is to create more courses, likely to create some masterminds for entrepreneurs who want to build in the space. And so we plan to bring some together and go through some training on just different dynamics and different areas within Web3. So that's definitely coming. And yes, we do want to run an event, likely both digital events, and we will have some in-person events in the future as well.